Collagen peptides seem to be all the rage these days. So what are these collagen peptides that people are selling? They tend to be either in a powdered form or in a pill form, and they're basically just a bunch of different amino acids. These amino acids are either produced by your body, which are the non-essential amino acids, or they're required to be ingested through your diet, and these are the essential amino acids. Collagen peptide supplements are actually a mix of the same amino acids that you find in our collagen. Collagen production actually decreases in your body as you get older, so a lot of people have been taking collagen peptides to try to counteract the effects of aging. So some of the benefits that they're supposed to have, I don't know if they actually have them, but people have been taking collagen peptides to improve skin health, reduce wrinkles and dryness. Apparently it can help increase muscle mass and prevent bone loss and relieve joint pain. There have also been so many claims that taking collagen peptides could actually help somebody with Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. So the real idea is that for somebody with Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, we have a genetic mutation that makes our collagen faulty. So if we take amino acids, which make up collagen, then our collagen would be better off and less faulty, right? Actually, no, that's kind of wrong. So in order to discuss this, let's talk about a COL5A1 mutation in somebody with classical Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. That's just one of the classical EDS mutations. So COL5A1 is a gene that codes for a polypeptide chain, and a polypeptide chain is just a chain of different amino acids. In order to make a full collagen 5, you need two of these specific polypeptide chains, as well as another polypeptide chain from a different gene, COL5A2, which could also be a different mutation in classical EDS, fun fact. These three strands kind of spin together in a helix, and they make the full collagen 5. Now, in these peptide chains made from COL5A1, every third amino acid is a glycine. Glycine is just a common amino acid, it's the smallest amino acid. So for somebody with a missense COL5A1 mutation of this sort, that glycine is going to be replaced with a different, bulkier amino acid, which is actually extremely problematic. And I'm not really gonna talk about like the pathology of that and what that causes exactly and how, because that's sort of not the point of this video. If you're interested, let me know. So the fact that that glycine is no longer glycine, but rather a different amino acid that's bulkier, the chains are completely different and they're kind of messed up. They're weaker, they don't hold together as well. And that is what causes classical EDS in a certain subset of people. Now, let's go and think about taking collagen peptides. So if you have that type of mutation and you're missing the glycine in collagen 5, it doesn't matter if you're ingesting the amino acid, specifically glycine. Your body is not going to incorporate that glycine into the collagen 5 structure because its literal nucleotide sequence is not coding for that because you have a mutation. So that's why taking collagen peptides isn't going to work when it comes to this type of mutation. And even though I'm talking specifically about a COL5A1 mutation, and even more specifically, I'm just talking about a certain type of COL5A1 mutation, the ways in which taking collagen peptides could affect somebody with this exact type of mutation is kind of the exact same way that it affects somebody with a different type of EDS mutation, as in it doesn't do anything. But hopefully using COL5A1 as an example will help you understand how EDS sometimes works and also why exactly taking these amino acids would not help somebody with EDS because of their EDS. Does that make sense? So if you're wondering whether or not it's actually beneficial to take these collagen peptide supplements, if not for EDS, but just for the other health impacts or benefits, I really don't know. I don't know anything on that. I don't know if they're legitimate or if they're not. It's possible that somebody could be deficient in amino acids or in a specific amino acid, and in that case, then taking those supplements could help them maybe. But the thing is that somebody with EDS is not deficient in those amino acids, and that's like very important to say. It doesn't mean you can't have EDS and also be deficient, but what I'm saying is that EDS is not going to cause you to be deficient in those amino acids. So in conclusion, taking supplementary amino acids will not help somebody with EDS, and I really find it problematic that people are making claims that it will help Ehlers-Danlos syndrome simply because we're talking about collagen supplements and we have a collagen problem. That doesn't mean that it's going to fix it. I've just been seeing it all over support groups, people claiming that it'll work, and also some people, you know, sharing their experiences, which is totally fine. Like, I'm not against you sharing your experience. So I wanted to come on here and clear that up and also give you an actual reason as to why they won't help with that. So thank you so much for joining me on this video, and I will see you on the next one. Bye.